Good morning, one and all. This is Dr. Chaitanya Krishna, professor of EC department. Now I am dealing with subject electromagnetic fields and waves. In this electromagnetic fields, what is the electromagnetic field? Means in which area and in which field the electric field properties and magnetic field properties satisfies that field we can call as a electromagnetic fields. The applications of these electromagnetic fields are the antennas and microwave that all are used in the electromagnetic fields. That's why in this subject we have to discuss about this electric field and magnetic fields and combinedly the electromagnetic fields. In that field that satisfy the electric field characteristics as well as magnetic field characteristics also. After this, electrostatic fields and magnetostatic fields, depending upon these two fields, we have to produce some waves. That waves we can call as the electromagnetic waves. Means that waves are satisfy the conditions of the electric field properties as well as magnetic field properties also. But in this, before going to the subject, the electromagnetic fields, we have to characteristics of the electromagnetic fields in a different types of the mediums and different types of the fields. That's why the first we have to discuss about the electromagnetic electric field and magnetic fields. We have to discuss in the static fields. What is mean by this static fields? What is mean by the static fields? Means the field which are we have to take in that area is not depends on the time varying. Means this is a static field. There is no any time is there in that field. There is no any time varying. Means with respect to time, there is no variation is there with time equal to zero. There is no involvement of the time. Then the field we can call as a static field. Now we have to discuss about the what is electric field characteristics are there in static field. That's why we can talk about this electrostatics. What are these electrostatic fields characteristics are there? What is the electric field is there? What are the different characteristics? What are the different topics are there in the electrostatic fields without involvement of time? Now, in this electrostatic fields, we have to discuss about this electrostatic fields. The electric field characteristics depends upon the point charges and continuous charge distributions. What are the electrostatic fields are there? These electrostatic fields we have to discuss in this point charges as well as continuous charge distribution. Here in this electrostatics and electric field, the main important element is the charge element. Based upon this charge element and movement of this charge only the electric field and charge and current and voltage are generated. That's why the main important element in this electrostatic field is the charge. That charge we can take in this electrostatics, we have the two types. One is the point charges and second one is the continuous charge distributions. Continuous charge distribution. Now we can based upon these two point charges and continuous charge distributions, the electrostatic characteristics, different topics are there where depends upon these charges, movement from one place to another place, or depending upon the direction, which direction we have to transmit the charge from one place to another place, that all are involving in this electrostatic fields. The basic thing is we have to movement of the charges, the movement of charges. That's why the basic law involving in this electrostatics is the Coulomb's law. The basic law involving basic theorem or basic law involving in this electrostatics or electric field we can call it Coulomb's law. Is Coulomb's law, it states that the movement of the charge, or we can apply some force on the particular charge element to move one place to another place. If charge is movement will occur, then only the electric field will be generated. That's why the basic law in this electrostatics is the Coulomb's law. This Coulomb's law states that force in between force in between the two point charges that is directly proportional force in between the two point charges directly proportional to the multiplication of magnitudes of the point charges as well as the inversely proportional to distance in between these two point charges for example here here the Q1 point charges is there, here the Q2 point charges is there. We can apply the force in between these two. And this distance in between these two point charges is the R. Then the force in between these two point charges is directly proportional to magnitudes of the two point charges and inversely proportional to square of the distance in between the two point charges. Now we can equate this equation with some constant F equal to K into Q1 Q2 by R square. Now K is a constant. The K equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught in farads per meter. And in this K, here epsilon naught value is there. This epsilon naught is the free space permittivity, that is also constant in free space permittivity. That free space permittivity epsilon naught equal to 8.854 into 10 to the power of minus 12 meters per farad. This is about the Coulomb's law. This Coulomb's law states that the force in between the two point charges equal to or force in between the two point charges is directly proportional to magnitudes of the multiplication of the two point charges and inversely proportional to the distance in between these two point charges. Now here this is the depending upon the point charge. Now involving any direction, if we can apply the force in any direction. Now up to now we can discuss the force applying between these Q1 and Q. Now we have to discuss in particular direction we have to apply the force. What will happen? If we can apply the force in particular direction, what will happen? Now here, for example, here the origin is there. For example, here the origin, here the Q1 point charges and here the Q2 point charges is there. And we can, here the Q1 point charges is there. If we can apply the force in this direction, we can apply the force in between these direction means we can call it the F12. Means we can apply the force in first point charges due to the which direction? Q2 direction. That's why we can write as a F12. And if we can apply the force in between these two means F21. The distance in between these two is the R. These all are based upon this. From R into this distance is the R1 and this distance is the R2.